Okay, the stream should be good to go. Wheel. So, oh yeah, you're here. Nice. Perfect. Yeah. Perfect. Okay, so let's go. Oh. See if we can get a whole shot here. So the stream might be a little bit laggy here for a while. And it looks like a few Yamaha guys up front there. We have Maximilian Genot and Francis Heder at the moment. So Francis Heder with a good start here. I believe it was Fred Heder last week. Had a really good race, so two Heder brothers here. Cool to see. Behind him, we have Alex Carlo and Dennis Fjellberg. Fjellberg probably went down, so we are going to find Fjellberg. He's dropping way back, 24th. So Francis Heder is still in lead before Alex Carlo. And then we have Conor Lins just charging. So this could be pretty disastrous for Dennis because I know Conor had the fastest lap time for a while there. I think Dennis edged him out in the end. At least it looked so, and that is the 984 of perhaps Antonio Garcia. Yep. Launching his way through. And I have n oh, there's my phone. So quite a few. I don't want to say new guys, but guys that usually aren't in the top really up here. So that's fun to see. We have Francis Heder, Alex Carlo, Conor Lins, Antonio Garcia, Stefano Guido, Rigo Delat, Mikey Wallet, Elliot Phillips, Michael Bicendic, Alana Shulis, Brooke Poppy. Oh, I can actually see Poppy. Ryan Turner. Oh, yeah, he moved up a class. That's why he wasn't in my race. Going over the bars. Fred Heder, Nick Jusic, Tristan Bartram, Ryan Turner again, Chase Dunnemath, Tim Friedrich, Thomas Benton, Jacob Holgersson, Sir Cross, Reid Young, Logan Thiepe, De Mol Farbares, Dennis Fjellberg, all the way back in 29th. Now up to 27th. So that is the start here. So Francis Heder launching onto the start here for yet another lap. Oh, and look at Conor Lins. I do wonder why Francis took that line, as I believe both the outsides and the second inside rut is faster. And Conor Lins charging too much, apparently going over the berm. And we do have Reid Young on a 125, I believe, in 18th. So some two strokes out there as well. And the guy in third behind these guys is Alex Carlo. So Carlo just dropping down one position as far. So Conor going for the inside line here. Let's see. It does pay off actually, but Francis do have a better drive through, unfortunately for Conor. But fun to see people switching up lines actually, and I do believe that people, if they want, can switch up the lines pretty good here. Terrible turn. Quite big ruts in it. That was Alex Carlo in the background sliding out. This is going to be interesting. I think we saw people going through here last lap. So Conor favoring the inside jumping up. Francis to the outside. I believe the outside looked a little bit faster. At least with the speed you're coming out of with. Sorry, I just need to have the chat. Or need, but it's always nice to have the chat. So I believe we missed Francis' mistake there for Jetler frame. So Alex Carley in the lead. Conor Lynn's not feeling the track at the moment. Antonio Garza going up, and this is his first pro season. Got bumped up after Supercross after winning the title. Literally everyone crashed down there. It was Guido and Francis Heller, my bad. I do believe we see Rico De Latt as well going up here, and I believe he moved up from Supercross as well to the pro ranks, trying his luck here. So Alex Carlo with the 2 seconds lead over Conor Lynn's. But I do wonder how long that is going to last, because Conor Lynn's can be blazing fast at times. Unless he makes mistakes, I will say. But Alex Carlo with a mistake, leaving the lead to Conor Lynn's to take over. And we do have Antonio Garcia in third, looking hungry for... Should have had my laptop here. Sorry, looking at the chat there. People wanting to re-grab the UIDs before Moto 1, and I don't get why people complain, because it's the same for everyone. If you are in qualifying position though and does not get grabbed, that's a whole other thing. That has happened to me as well. But if you're in the server or if you just miss the timing UID grab, it's totally that person's fault. So Alex Carlo second place, Rico De Latt third. So Rico apparently taking over third, and his teammate Michael Bucendik back and fourth. And then we have Antonio Garcia, fifth. Another Yamaha guy. Another team though from TGM Designs. Switch from, they used a KTM 250s in the Supercross. I don't think there was any 450 riders. So now switching to Yamaha apparently. Francis Heller, currently in sixth. So four Yamaha guys in a row, that's pretty good. I believe versus PC, Connor in the lead should be Honda, and Alex Carlo, I actually don't know. Moto chasing. Connor just stretching out his lead already. And in 14th place, we find Dennis Fjellberg. I would say that he and Connor are currently the two guys fighting for this championship. And Fjellberg trying too hard to do that line. And that's such a sketchy line. I would suggest more or less everyone to go to the outside and just be safe. But apparently that's not going to happen. So we'll have to stick with this, I guess. So in front of Fjellberg we have Brock Pappi, Jacob Holgersson, Fred Heller and Jordan Moxie. Moxie currently in 10th. Guido trying to recover after the fall, you know, before the finish line. Together with, I believe that was Francis Heller. And Tristan Borrem battling out with Flo Lucasson, or at least trying to catch him. And I believe Flo is actually in the top 5 in points here. I'm going to see if I don't inform you guys wrong, but I believe Flo is currently holding top 5 in points in the 250 class. As you can see here, Flo Lucasson currently 5th with 120 points, Stephanie Guido in 4th with 126 points, so pretty close actually to... pretty close to each other. Oh, and Flo just getting off schedule. Tristan with a good drive after going single up there, and I think Tristan's not done here. Looks like he's ready for chasing after Francis Heller for that would be 6th. Should be streaming. Wait, I gotta check here. Sorry for this. I'll be back really, really soon. Sorry. Just a few more seconds and I'll be good to go. So, stream should be going. So let's get back into this. And Conor Lane's already getting into Lapras. Oh, terrible. We're only... oh, it's actually lap 7, so it's been faster than I thought it would be. Can I really see who that was getting lapped? That was 157 of Nick Jusic. Nick currently in 31st. So Connor having a big lead over Michael Bjendik in 2nd place. Michael followed by his teammate Rico. Quite close behind, both riding for Cycle Trader Yamaha. And Tristan Bodrum getting around, is that Antonio Garcia for 4th? So Tristan making passes. I think he was wearing Francis Heller last time I saw him. And Francis Heller is currently residing in... trying to find him. Eighth. My eyes are bad, obviously. So looking through here, we can see that Dennis Fjellberg is making passes through the pack, and Conor Lins. Ooh, what happened there? Is that a lag out? Ooh, that might be. Ooh, that sucks. So I wonder if Conor just... I don't think I can see him here. But I wonder if that's just a temporary lag out or something, because that seems really, really weird. I mean, that's happened before and people come back half a lap after, out of nowhere. So Michael Bjendik leading what I assume is his first pro race, or leading this far into the race at least. It's not his first pro race, but I believe he's leading... as I said, it's far into the race. Looks like Logan Deepade, Rich Quit, Elliot Phillips, and Jen Brignion as well. And Rico Delat, solid second place in the moment. just a few seconds off of his teammate. Tristan Bottom, third place now. Finally top three for this guy. That's somebody standing right there. Oh, too bad. Can you see who that was? Tony Garcia. Dennis Fjellberg. So Fjellberg in the top five. Fastest lap time of a 140. Believe that's the fastest lap time of the race. I cannot find anyone that has a faster lap at the moment. Jordan Moxie with a 141.9, but Dennis with a 149, so that's still faster. So Connor Lynn's connected again. That sucks. Aaron Hall saying that he will DDoS Jake Rose. Aaron Hall DDoSing Jake Rose for 10 bucks. I would like to see that one. Because Aaron's usually having trouble with the internet connection, he tells me. So I wonder if DDoS is such a good thing to do then. And Antonio Garcia dropped down one position here, also being passed by Jordan Moxie, and you get carry so much speed out of that turn. If the other guy is just slightly behind you, they have no way of making it before you if they aren't crossing your line out of that turn. And that would be some guy. I wonder who that was. On the way there. 168 or 188 perhaps. Can't really see who that was. Looks like we have a battle for the lead. We looked for a while, but that was a lap at 293. Jeffrey Tremier. So I believe Dennis is going to catch Tristan here. Looking lap times, Tristan with a 142 as best, and Dennis with a 140.2. So I would believe that Dennis is going to have him in no time. So to me, this is just a matter of time when the pass is going to happen, and Tristan having to deal with a lapper, Dennis get a clear track. Sketchy jump though, too much acceleration bumps, I'm aware. And it looks like Geoffrey isn't doing too much to get off the track or get out of the way, but it looks like he was out of the way now though for the faster guys, fortunately. Dennis, not a new best lap time, but a 140.5. Still really, really fast. Not many guys that can match that. And a free third place for Dennis here. Bad news for the other guys, he only has 10 seconds lead up to the front, or 7 seconds even. So Dennis is probably going to catch Rico here in just a second, unless he crashes. Michael, honestly, not too far in front of Rico. So all of these guys were wearing really, really solid. Oh, yeah, it was me, Shakers, making this one. So thanks a lot there. Traction was changed in the last section to this. It was slippery before. It was sort of... should have gone somewhere in between, I think. And Maxim Tyson mainly did a decal job on this track. I believe Aaron Hall did a bit too. So I mean, the track itself and Tis and Aaron worked on the decals. And Fjellberg now up to second place. So Fjellberg, second place here after being 24th to 30th somewhere in the start here with a really, really bad start. So probably very, very consistent. So this is going to be really interesting to see. Thanks, Jiggers. If you have anything to give him not negative but constructive criticism, I would say, I would really appreciate that. I do have gotten complaint about acceleration bumps out of some turns, or anyone else. I really appreciate feedback. So Danny is so close to Rico, and honestly, that's a little bit scary close because that's in the margin of error for lag. So if Rico would lag the slightest, Dennis would instantly die. Oh, Rico going over the turn. I was just about to say that it looks like Anthony Garcia in third, or Michael Bujandic, my bad, was catching Dennis. Michael with a 1:42 as the best lap time. So that's sort of awkward. Felt like Dennis was catching so fast and pulling away from everyone else, and then all of a sudden, Michael is sort of great. Coming together with Dennis. And Dennis sketchy line up there again. I can't believe that these guys are not switching the lines up. So insane. And that's number 475 getting lapped, pulling off the track. Really respectful. No stupid entry as well. So Dennis is now to first place here. I don't really know what we should do at this point. So, Rico Delat and Tristan Bortram here. Tristan Bortram from TBM Racing, battling out with Rico Delat on Cycle Trader Yamaha. That is the battle for third, and back in the background there we have Jordan Moxey right after these guys. Jordan Moxey running for Mad Cape. Unfortunately, I can't see his skin. Well, I think you do know Planet Shakers. I haven't tried the last two tracks. I have been so fed up with doing this track. So I can't believe that you guys pulling off pushing tracks out so many. I know you probably make more than my two tracks to for this year, so unbelievable work you guys do. But as you said, Shakers stated here that people want the speed. Want to pin it like MX versus ATV, but want to realism like MXS. That's the problem, like you have to choose sort of technical and unpleasant, and that's real and simulator, or you have to have wide open, big jumps, big berms. I don't know. It's sort of, you can't have both worlds. You can have one and a half, I guess, but that's the most. Okay, so Brandon saying stop playing this game. I was actually thinking about you, Brandon, the other day here, where because you're one of the faster guys here that I really wonder where you are or where you were, because you're one of the faster guys I missed for the season, really. And thanks for wishing me good luck. I believe the battle is only between Jordan Moxey and Alex Carlo dropping down to sixth. Still pretty good. But Dennis Fjellberg up in the lead. 6 seconds, roughly 6 seconds back to Michael Bujanic. So Michael moving up, I think, to Nationals, so just for the last round. Marty Party, what's up, dude? Rico Delat still staying stronger, so Rico showing a lot of progression. He was really learning a lot in Supercross and really getting his speed on point. But he seems to have improved quite a lot as well for outdoors. Really interesting to see here. As I say, so he chokes slightly, and that is going to allow Tristan Bortram to get around, and Jordan Moxey as well. So he's going to lose two spots for that little mistake. So Rico not dropping too much back. Francis Heder dropping back from the lead though. Back into the seventh. That is somebody staying on the side of the track. 969 of Reid Jung, I would say. Really respectful to show other riders to pass. Just realize as I speak that my phrasing is so bad. Because I do change my sentence in mid-sentence, like I start in one way and then in another. I do that in Swedish as well, and yes, Mother Party, I am from Sweden. Antonio Garcia, 9th, Flo Lucasson, 10th, Guido, 11th, oh, catching Ri Jong, just right, oh, and he is taking Jacob Holgersson down. That was super bad judgment from Guido there. Guido should have just checked up, and as the rule states, use the backup button to turn around. And that was Ryan Turner that got around Guido there, as well as Jacob Holgersson. Brooke Poppy now up to 13th, Guido 14th, Tim Friedrich, Thomas Pento, Ben Seaberg. Ben Seaberg not being as consistent as he needs to be, because he's one of the top riders, can't say all the time, but most of the time, that he really came off strong last year, and he showed such a progression curve, but all of a sudden he just more or less stopped, and he sort of became very inconsistent, especially in Supercross. He had a really, really hard time. But he has had a better time here in Nationals, though. He has had a few sweet races. But I don't know. Oliver Albertsson, 18th, and my boy Chase Dunvant here, 19th. Oliver Albertsson was 18th, my bad, and so across. But it looks like Dennis is going to lap Chase Dunvant, and Chase Dunvant not putting up a fight, so Dennis just moves right on there. If we look at this, Dennis' fastest lap is 1:39.7. I think Valtteri is going to race today. He did send me his skin, so I really hope so. And when I hear that, I don't even know if I downloaded the skins, actually. That's sort of crappy by me. I should have gotten them, I think. But I wonder if this is actually something that happened to Dennis, if Michael's just been that close. I did notice that Dennis had a 1:45 last time, which is a few seconds off of his pace. It's still really, really good. In amateur, it would be quite a good lap, as most guys were 1:44, 1:45s. But Michael being really impressive is showing a lot of speed and nevertheless consistency. Really good here. Tristan Bodram, 3rd place. Looking good there. Followed by Jordan Moxie still. So these guys still battling it out after a few laps. I think Moxie really, really wants to get into that third podium place. Spanish tracks, that's a tough one. I'm not sure, because in the schedule we have the craters. There's like the names of the tracks, not necessarily the countries. We do have Arco, but I'm not sure if that one is. So Arco di Taranto, I'm not sure if that's Spanish or Italian, really. Mantova, I believe it's Italian. It's a tough call. I really, really don't know. But I can check on my phone here and see if I see anything that seems Spanish. If I could get some help, which GP tracks are Spanish, that would really help. Let's see. Jordan Mox is still really, really trying to get in there. May 29th, Talavera. Let's see. I don't think. It seems like we should have Talavera in, actually. So Talavera should be in there. It's preliminary schedule to round 8. As I said, tracks are still not final, really. As we speak, we're trying to get tracks together. So I don't really know how that's going to come along. I don't know if anybody started on Talavera yet, or how we are going to do that. But Rico Delat betting a lot with Fred Heder here. Fred Heder currently trying to get into the top 5 that Rico has. different lines again, and people seem to want to jump up there. And as I say, so I didn't realize I had already gone almost 29 minutes. Dennis Fjellberg with a win, followed by Michael Bjelland. And 299, that is Jordan. No, that's Tristan Barham, then Jordan Moxie. So Berlinson here for fifth. But I believe Rico will have that, because that's quite a lot of time to make up in one turn. I mean, there's always penalty as well. Not really sure. But Rico taking fifth. Fred is sixth. Alex Carlo actually really close to seventh. Francis Herrer close to Alex Carlo. Antonio Garcia. Flo Lucasson. Jacob Holgersson. Brock Puppy followed by Ryan Turner. So all these guys so close together. I would say that the top 13 at least, there was no rider really separated by more than around 10 seconds. Apparently had 24 seconds there between 4th and 5th, as I missed. But other than that, it was really, really close racing. Guido going to come in 14th. Tim Friedrich 15th. Ben Seberg, Thomas Bento, Maximilian Janot, and Oliver Albertsen. Let's see here. We have a switch here actually for 4th. Tristan Bodram is going to get 3rd, and Jordan Moxie. Moxie 3rd, Bodram 4th. Wait there. Bodram 4th, I believe. Moxie 3rd, Lat 4th, Fred, and Flo Lucasson getting 9th instead of Tony Garcia. And that are the changes in the top 20. Oh wow, naming it wrong. I'm just gonna see if I can restart my game here real quick. Be right back. Sorry, trying to talk without having anything there. That's weird. So Tianan, let's see if I can get the game going. Doesn't want to start up. I believe it's still loading skins, although I'm starting to question that. I'll be right back. So I'm back. Nick, are you there?
Oh. Yep, I just made another coffee, and I'm back now.
Perfect. So, let's see here. Getting the racing underway. Getting in game, so let's see if I got people's skins here. Otherwise, it's embarrassing. I do see Tiana. Oh, wow, I did remember to download something. That's 1,000 points to me.
There you go.
I can see a lot of people's skins. Nice. Let's see what I cannot see. I cannot see. 3 of 5 edit Suzuki. Porks, apparently. Sending me his skins.
I don't think they posted it anywhere in the EMF screens, right?
They ran Suzuki, so I'm quite sure I've seen him before.
Oh.
Perhaps I haven't.
Weird.
I
don't know.
Jake Rose, I could see half of him. Okay, that's interesting.
That's weird.
I guess why not? So who do we expect it here for? Oh, really? Walter's back? For that, I see some ban, but I guess not. Bruno! He did complain about me not seeing him on the last streams, I guess. Guess I should address that. Focusing on him and start. Oh, can't I reset the cameras for some reason? Really? Oh, that sucks.
Cameras work for me.
Yeah, they're fine. I just zoomed in, but I didn't really want to zoom in.
Oh, gotcha.
I don't think there's any really.
I think I need to take the handguards off. They're less aerodynamic.
I guess. Oh, shoot. Well, we'll have to speak to Bruno from this angle there. I guess that's fine too. The girl sliding off track. Bruno on his husky. Oh, shaking up, Bruno. Almost getting punted either way, but it is Valtteri Tiana with a good start here. Followed by Nixon
Tyson.
Oh, that was a
massive hole shot.
Jordan Boyer. Somebody getting sideways. Oh, getting so down.
Oh, a lot of people going sideways. Inside of the jump. Oh, no.
It's almost looking like amateurs. Amateurs. Oh, wow. Somebody front. Oh, it's so many people. I wonder how many people had spotters, and if they had spotters, it's really embarrassing. Especially for the people crashing in the back, but Tiana in the lead. Solid, really. Followed by Jake Rose. Both of these guys switched versus PC very recently. So Rose also on a 450, that's weird, I guess. So Rose actually into the lead, I didn't realize as I was looking at chat for a moment. So Jake Rose into the lead. Not what I expected, to be honest. But Tiannan's all over him, so I believe Tiannan would be passing him. And he passes. Shakes up nicely as well. Great. Not getting taken down. Tiannan to the inside. Has the benefit of the lower kick. Not going to help him, really. Oh, I wish I had my laptop. I would mute quite some guys, I can say. So Tiana now passed Rose, and third place is Yannick Müller. And I do see his skins. I actually did download them. That's amazing for me.
There you go.
Anytime I can see somebody's skin, I'm happy. And
I'm gonna load the stream to make sure it's working. I'm not sure if you did that already.
I have one. It's currently paused, but I do you see the viewer account. Müller with a good move, blocking off the outside.
15. There we go.
So Müller, this would be his home track, since he's German. So he told me he really, really wanted a race.
Track is amazing too. Not only what you did, but the layout in general is so much fun.
Yeah, I mean, big shout out to Tyson and I believe Aaron to a certain bit as well for working on the details. Tyson made it so good with the overlay and stuff, so you can see all the bumps and stuff, because that usually can get lost. And that was Jake Rose, unfortunately, going face first into the berm. So Tyson is going to get by, and Tyson trying to double out, not the smartest thing to do as he goes down. What's up, Jerem? 899. Yeah, we ban people for high ping. That is, it's really impossible to have a close battle with high ping, and it usually just ruins people's races, so that's the way it is here in EMF. But there is, if you're from Australia or America, there are a series so-called Australian MXSGP hosted, and that's on American servers, so that's another shot for people with high ping. But Tiano followed by Mueller. Mueller, wow, what a launch up that. Looks like Tim Geiser. And that, at this point, it's quite a good thing to say. So Mueller looking so fast, catching Tiano. Tiano's not the easiest ready to catch, really. But it looks like Jannik is motivated. These guys are number 10 and 11. I guess both of them has earned career number. Alexander Lagerqvist, what's up in chat, or Aquas Gaming. Aquas Sweden. Anyway. So how's your race going?
It was alright. First race in like a month, I think, so.
That's good. And I gotta say, these guys, both guys in the 138 zones. I believe they qualified with a 135 Tiana. That was insane on Mueller.
Wow.
146, I would say. So they are super fast, these guys. And Matthias Liedman now up to 4th place. But it looks like Tiano is starting to expand the lead here. Not sure if Mueller made this mistake or just not able to keep the pace up. Yeah, I have internet problems too. So, definitely know that thing. So Tyson third, Liedman fourth, and behind Liedman we have Hunter Root. So this could potentially be really interesting. Interesting line choices by Root as well. Liedman almost catching Root there. I mainly stream EMF Supercross and Motocross races. I think I've occasionally streamed something else, but that's the main ones I do. I believe I streamed Monster Cup as well. The EMF one.
Alright.
So Root now up to 4th, Liedman 5th. Wanna see here what Root can pull for a lap time, because I think this could be a potentially really fast lap.
This looked like it.
So let's see. Coming in at 142. Apparently not that good of a lap. And back up into the top two here, we can see that both guys are running 140s, so still keeping the same seconds of a lap. Quite insane. Thanks, dude. So Tyson, not that far off. Hillman battling it out to Matt LeMoyne. I believe I saw LeMoyne in 6 recently, so I believe Hillman made the pass. And Hillman looks fast for sure.
Yep.
Looks like he's on a mission at the moment, I believe. Looking from his speed, it really looks like the GP track, so like and like, but it looks like Nationals more than Supercross. That's for sure. Not sure if he feels that way, but his results tells that. So Matt LeMoyne falling behind, Jake Rose now down to 8th. That's still really good, especially for being the first year in the pro class. Jordan Boyer 9th, battling with Dora Marot, and I would say that Dora Marot is probably
inside.
Oh, Jordan Boyer holding the inside. Marot doing the same.
Oh, the weakest scrubs I've ever seen.
Boyer locking the front wheel in the jump there. I believe that was the guy that killed everyone on the first lap.
Oh,
that's
really?
That's a sketchy track entry by Doria Marat, actually. That's really sketchy. Cutting right in front of Bruno Goslar. So Bruno, 12th. He called me out last time for not showing him on stream, so let's go on board with Bruno on the stream here. So Bruno, I believe the owner for FKF Motorsports, I might be wrong, at least a rider for them.
By the way, he's an EMF admin.
Yes, he is.
There we go.
So both EMF admins in the top 15, that's in this race. Bruno looking good. Looks like he's been practicing a lot and actually picked up quite a lot of speed. Like we were bad in front of here. Hardcore jumper. What's up? So Matt LeMoyne trying to get Dura Merritt. And Dura Merritt in his turn is trying to get Arno Ponslet. That's trying to get Niklas Jenkins. Congratulations, Michael. For the first podium. But it looks like Dura Merritt made a pass on Ponsa there. Oh, Merritt going over the bar. That's not where you want to go, and that is going to allow Bruno to pass here. And one more guy, yeah, no, that was perhaps Bruno and Jordan Bowyer. And Jack Fowler, yep, as well, so quite a few guys actually getting...
Three? That's not good.
Yeah.
One mistake, that's where this track is.
And on this track as well, there's quite a few blind spots that you can't really tell, and there's a lot of singles and whatnot, so, ooh, that's a few guys down.
Yeah.
LeMoyne, Bowyer, Ponsa, I believe.
Yeah, that's Ponsa.
So Bruno now in the top 10 here. Really great racing. So 10 out of 34. Going back up in
line,
we can see that we have, that's Chris Channing leaving TNN a lot of room. Nice there. So TNN with the lead. Are you kidding me? 137.5. Mueller 137.9 is his best lap time. Insane. Third place we have Hunter Root now, so Root making up ground in front of Maxim Tyson, and Hillman's actually up to fifth now. Jake Rose down with Liedman. I would have liked to see that crash, because I know that Liedman usually is sort of not very aggressive. So we'll have to see if I get a angry text after the race. Niklas Jenkins going down, Bruno's going to get by. So Bruno just picking up
positions. Ooh, some lapper just cartwheeled down the pit lane. Who was that? Got out to Chris Channing. Who flipped it on a straight.
No, I did not see that, Rico. You have to file a protest if we should see that, I guess. So Hunter Root now to Yannick Mueller after Mueller made a mistake. Mueller with another mistake as well, so Mueller just going down, and that's Maxim Tyson on the inside.
Oh.
Doubling. So Tyson feeling hot. So this is really, really interesting now, because Mueller is starting to work his way downwards, unfortunately, in the standings.
Well, that was Hunter Root that was down. These two both just made a position.
Oh wow, Root down, that's not very often that happens. But
I
want to see here
one off.
What happens with Mueller and Tyson here.
Now a battle for second.
Yeah. So we have had quite a few great battles here today. And to update you on points here, coming into the round I was sort of thinking that Tiana probably had a points lead, but I was very, very wrong, because Tiana has missed the two last races, unfortunately. So he's currently in sixth with 114 points. Maxim Tyson is fifth with 119 points. Fourth is Matthew Mazeron with 131. Third is Matthias Liedman, 155. Second is Dura Merritt, 188, and Hunter Root in first place with 192. And Hunter Root has missed one race, while Marrott 4 points behind has missed zero races. So, really interesting here. And as I've read from my phone, I haven't realized that Tyson has gone down. Fell back. Oh, Root going over the bars. Tyson is going to get his position back.
That's two in the space of a lap.
But this track's tricky though. You have to be on your watch. Especially with the kickers that's here and there. But it's nice to feel.
Yeah, the switchbacks really get me.
Switchbacks. These ones that Owen's in.
After you go over the roller, that's Yannickson. Turn four and then this one.
Yeah. Yeah, they are quiet.
Yeah, they catch me out all the time.
Root is trying to make the move here on Hillman, but Hillman's looking good. Hillman's been on fire lately, so I don't believe he'll put out. I believe he'll put out quite a battle here for Root to see. Let's see here. Different lines, looks like Hillman's was faster, but Root has the better option to get any line he wants out of that, while Hillman has to accept whatever he gets, as he's jumping so much further. Taking different lines here as well. Oh, Hillman's getting over sideways, but managed to stay up on the track. Let's see here, both going low over. Oh Hillman.
Swap.
Swapping out, you call it. Let's see if...
Oh, Yannick just went down. He's gonna lose his spot to Maxime.
Really?
There he goes.
Yep,
second place, Maxime Tyson.
And Hunter Root's really
close
to
Jen. Oh, and he throws it away!
Did he try to double?
He did, and then his rear wheel lost traction. He just kind of did like a half-assed 360.
Oh, that sucks. But Yama with the 40-second lead. Wow.
Yeah, he's gone.
Or 38 seconds, that's close enough to 40, I would call it. So Yannick Müller, the German, his home track, second place. If he can win the Motos 2 here, he'll walk away with the overall. But he has one hungry Hunter Root behind him, so I doubt it will be too much to happen. So Yannick just trying to fend off Hunter at the moment. Both guys getting over clean, and Yannick off the track. Can't double up, so Hunter is going to claim the spot. Yannick with a mistake, apparently. So Tianen just going fourth. Root second place, Yannick third. And I would say that if Valtteri doesn't mess up big time, he does have the win here.
Yeah, something catastrophic would have to happen.
Yeah, especially with these pro guys, they're so consistent. But Tyson, 4th place still, Hillman 5th. Dura Merritt 6th, so Merritt not able to have the race they probably wants to. I always think it's interesting to spectate these guys when they're launching, because the guys that are managed to launch over the sort of, I don't know, hole, can get so much more speed than the guys landing in it. If they just launch like mid or full.
Mm-hmm.
Probably just me noticing. No one else cares, I guess. So Jake Rose, 7th place. Liedman unfortunately down to... Oh, swapping out. Damn it, Liedman. So Liedman swapping out, going to lose a bunch of positions to bunch of different guys here. Jordan Boyer's the final. Oh, swapping out as well? What is this? Morgan.
I don't know.
Everyone's swapping out here. And I mean, this isn't that hard of a section either.
They're straight bumps.
Yeah, I mean, and they're not big either. I would understand probably any other section than that one. But Matthias Liedman, Jack Fowler got around. Fowler looking good. I have the 450 demo. It's probably going to be uploaded later tonight or tomorrow to the forum. And Jack Fowler, unfortunately, losing the front end. Mathias Lehmann going to get lapped by Valtteri Tianan. Bruno, 10th place. So Bruno still top 10 here, going strong. Nicholas Jenkins right in front of Bruno. Hashtag Rico fan club. Cool, I guess. Chris Channing needs to be banned, so I guess we have to go back and watch Chris Channing, see if he does anything inappropriate.
I think Mathias Lippmann just got lapped in 11th.
I think so too. I've seen Tianan lurking behind him, so I wouldn't be surprised by that.
He's way in front. Next up is Bruno, and he's in 10th.
Yeah, Bruno's having a
really good... This guy's doing a top 10, and before 20 minutes, he's getting lapped. Insane.
I don't know, Chris Channing seems to be quite conservative at the moment. I don't think he needs to be banned. Arnold Ponsler, was that a rage quit? Seems so. Steen Elshoff battling with Ty Casey. Or, my bad. Alex Munch going off the track. So back into the lead. We now have Valtteri Tianan with best lap time of a 1:37.1. Through traffic, insane. 45 seconds lead. This guy is killing it at the moment. Yannick Müller, second place. Home track.
Oh, Hunter's going for the triple.
Really? Did he do it?
Yeah, he hit it.
Oh, I wanted to see that. I made all those...
expect him around a lap. He hit it the lap before as well. So it looks like he can do it consistently.
Oh. That was the whole reason why there's so many acceleration bumps in that part. To sort of disable that triple. Or at least disable people doing it lap after lap after lap. Because you could so easily hit it when the track was flat. It was just so simple. With the first version traction, you can really hit it.
Yeah. But then again, Hunter Root is not a human. We all know that. Whoa. That was very close in the run in the back of the 72.
I'm sorry if I'm out here. I'm just going to listen.
Yeah, it's all good.
You can talk though. That's good.
Put the camera on Hunter Root.
Just have to go and check on my dog and see how he's doing.
Oh, I backed out.
So I'm back here. Hunter Root with a fast line through that section, that's for sure. Oh, almost getting together with someone.
Belcher had a bad lap, and that bad lap was only at 1:45.
That's one of, that was probably one of my better laps in my race. 1:43
yeah,
to 1:45.
A second slower than my qualifying time.
It's insane. Good luck, Rico, in the next race.
Yeah, so, Rico. I'm not gonna clean you out, I promise. Not gonna try.
1.5 minutes to go before the 2-lap card comes out here.
That's gonna be 4 right now, 3 easy across the line.
Yeah. So 3 laps to go now.
Yep.
So let's see, I really missed Hunter. Does Hunter still triple?
He didn't the lap that you went away. I went away from him. Let's see if he does it this lap.
Yeah, I'm expecting it at the moment. And Yannick's really close, actually. I was surprised because I thought Yannick went away for some reason. Let's see if
Hunter... Oh, he has to back out now.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Didn't hit it properly.
I mean, to be honest, it's just stupid to hit that line
you
in the race.
You have to hit it absolutely perfectly.
Yeah.
Oh, and a lapper cleans him.
I don't think that was a clean, but that was just bad luck, I think.
That was very bad luck.
That's 4:12. That is...
Ty Casey.
Yep. Ty Casey. So bad luck there for... Oh, Hunter Root. Yannick got around him. It's a tough call. So Hunter is currently third, Owen Hillman fourth, and Tyson fifth, I believe those two swapped positions.
Looks like it. Owen has a real good moto going.
Yeah, for sure. Being top 5, I can't remember ever seeing Owen top 5 when I've streamed. If Hunter will catch Valtteri, there is absolutely no way he will catch him. Valtteri has a 48 seconds lead. Almost close to 50 seconds at the moment, well, even 50.
He has to disconnect.
Yeah, Valtteri is not going to lose 50 seconds in 2 laps. That is, unless somebody goes to just crash him. But I would kick that guy if I saw that happen, so I don't think that's going to happen. And especially not since Yannick is in front of Root as well. And looks like, oh, Owen Hillman, I don't know if he tried to clean up the lap or he just had a really weird line going.
It's gonna get passed by.
Yeah, no, only good to lose one spot.
There's a lapper getting up.
But I can say if this would have been 50 seconds difference, Root being in third and Valtteri first, and it would be the second lap, I would have not excluded the idea of Root catching Valtteri, honestly. But 50 seconds is much for any top guy to lose in the lead. So I don't think that's ever going to happen, really. So Dura Marot, Jake Rose down, going to be passed by Nicholas Jenkins on some lapper. And that is Bruno actually getting up to Jake Rose. So Bruno 9th. And that is Matthias Lehmann going to catch Bruno in 10th. So soon, I believe. But number 579, nicely moving to the side, to be Florent Lambillo. Great move.
This battle for second, oh my lord.
What is this? Jake Rose just let Bruno by, or did Jake get sideways?
Huh?
What if... Oh, dude. I would like to inspect that and see if that had anything to do with something that happened before, because that looked like Jake shaked up and wanted to punt Bruno.
Oh. If you want to punt someone, don't do it, obviously, and don't make sure it's not an admin.
Bruno just closing Jake Rose off. Rose is going down hard. Oof. And
Hunter on the inside of Yannick for second place. Gonna get it.
And is this the last lap?
One more.
Oh yeah, for these guys.
For these guys.
On the last.
Oh, Hunter! He hits it!
So sketchy. But he didn't gain... Honestly, he did not gain much time.
It just looks really cool.
It's such a big line. Without the acceleration bumps, there would be no way. I wouldn't really.
You could do it on a 125, I guarantee it.
Yeah, I think I'd managed to do it on a 250. I built those bumps. But that's about it. There's no way I would ever consider doing that in the race. 450, 500, 700, I don't care. No way. Too much bumps. But and doing that double as well, I mean, it's fast. It's really fast, but so sketchy. Coming up a tad bit short on that's not going to be fun. But Valtteri on his way there to win. Having to check on my Bruno here and see how he and Jake are doing. Seems to be a few good battles going on, but I want to, for once, actually catch the finish line. And Dura Marot is probably going to be the last guy not being lapped. So Marot is going to be able to eventually work on. Oh, that's Hillman, so. But I want to see. Oh, Madimusion going down after trying to catch Liedman. So Bruno battling up Binu Kravitz, and Jordan Boyer, and Jake Rose sort of having a battle as well. So. This is for top 10. If Binut can catch Bruno, Binut will get top 10, otherwise Bruno will get it. Binut getting so sketchy. And this one jump you really don't want to whip, because that probably is the sketchiest jump on the whole track. Bruno going to the inside, covering the inside. Oh, getting too far to the inside, Binut will get him on the outside, I can guarantee. Oh, Bruno going strong on the outside, not letting Binut by. And Bruno is going to get 10th with 8 thousandths of a second. Oh my lord, that's close. And Jake Rose getting in front of Jordan Boyer. So let's see, I think we had a battle between. Let's see here, Mueller finishing. Nice whip. 3rd, Tyson going to go in 4th, and Marot probably 5th, unless he crashes. Somebody say, why is the stream not working? Could you verify, Nick, and see if it is lagging or something? And Hunter Root with. No, yeah, that's Valtteri Tiainen with a 1:36.8. Wow. So fast.
Is the server lagging by any chance?
Server?
Yeah.
Stream or EMF?
Offset. I'm getting massive offset.
I have 0, but I'm in warm up mode, so I don't really know.
Oh my.
Huh. No, that's probably just.
Damn, I'm just lagging then. Not fun. Opening the stream.
Let's see here. We have. The 8 thousandths of a second will not factor in here. We have Hunter Root with a bit penalty. Mueller as well. So does Tyson, and Marot, and Hillman. But nobody inside the top 20 is going to have a position. And that's your mayor? Oh, I totally did not see him during the race. 18th place, so the owner looking. So the owner actually back racing here for MX game servers.
Yeah.
I guess EMF as well, that's our own point. So Valtteri Tiainen, Hunter Root, Yannick Mueller, Maxim Tyson, Dura Marot, Owen Hillman, Nicholas Jenkins, Matthias Liedman, Matt Quinceron, Bruno Goslar, Binu Kravitz, Jake Rose, Jordan Boyer, Jack Fowler, Matt Agat, Robert Wilson, Morgan Mollet, John Mayer, Ethan Parks, and Logan Liezel for the top 20. And I can't
tell if the stream is broken or my internet doesn't want to load it.
But you can't really load the stream because I can't really seem to load the stream either. So,
okay, so then that's the it just freezes at the frame where you're typing a demo.
What? It just freezes at.
It's just like buffering at the frame when you're typing in the demo name.
Oh.
Oh. And it loads a different frame now. I don't know what it's doing.
Oh, well, I think. I would like to believe that on Twitch. I do see a moving stream at the moment, and there it froze.
Okay.
Because there's something at Twitch. I did some research, and what came up was that it's either me to Twitch or Twitch to each Twitch node, sort of like depending where you live.
Yeah.
And it seemed to be the Twitch thing because sometimes it just doesn't work at all. But you still have the whole stream as a video on demand working
That's good.
perfectly. But I don't know.
Oh, I got a 400 ping. I can't race. Damn it.
You got what? 400 ping.
400 ping.
Turn off the stream.
500. Oh, no, I have it off.
Oh, rip.
I don't think anything else is on, so GG.
Done. Log into your router and kick everyone else on the network. Or even better, ban them.
I'm gonna do a wheelie and then disconnect on the start. Damn. They really want to race.
I really want people to race. This is the first track I built. I did quite a bit
Freaking
on
internet.
Leon, but I did not. Oh, really? Instead of people getting called out, it was OMG, guys, please put the number. What a legendary.
Listen in.
And Dennis Fjellberg with a good start and Connor Lynch as well.
Damn, I want to race. This is pissing me off. Oh well. Is like the server rate way down or something?
I
By any
don't think
chance, like just.
so. What's your ping?
Yeah. It's jumping from 400 to 500. If it stays like this in the start, I'm just gonna disconnect. Put it that way.
Now you can commentate with me instead. I guess that's good too.
Yeah. As long as TeamSpeak isn't lagging, I don't think it is.
I haven't noticed on lag yet, so that's good.
Where is this TeamSpeak hosted, by the way? In
France.
France?
I
Okay.
believe at least. It is John Mayer, aka Nayubi, hosting the
Yeah.
TeamSpeak Academic Sim server.
Gotcha.
And some random guy, please put me in 250. Not
Yeah, for
going to
sure, bud.
happen. Because you need to be
Nah,
here
give
for
him
the
my spot.
VIP.
He's gonna go win. He's just gonna win. Trust me. Man, I was using the red gear. It looks so cool.
Sorry, I had to shake Skype there for a bit.
And I pray that the ping fixes itself. Oh, it's going down to 300 now. Big steps. Oh, damn it, still 400.
And Duke Rose complaining about the EMF because I think Bruno took him out once. I don't know what happened before. So,
Oh my.
yeah.
Well, I mean, it's loading the bikes quickly. The bike acknowledgements is going well.
That's good. Oh my god, my dogs are just racing around the apartment at the moment. Oh my god, I'm spamming that.
Ah, damn it. 400. Okay. Hello.
Okay, so let's spectate someone. So start for 250 Moto 2 going off here. Alexis Vanbrabant, currently the guy in focus, number 79. But it looks like Conor Lynch and Dennis Fjellberg with a good start. Dennis Fjellberg sliding out, totally expected. That first turn is not good at all.
Liberty.
I wonder who the guy without a name is. That is 475.
Yep.
Oh my lord. Name. Just trying to get that out there because if a guy is racing without a name, in my opinion, he deserves a ban. If I'm looking at the
Yeah.
chat, I have been. I didn't notice it was anything new. I thought I'd see it.
Yep. And you just got disconnected. I don't know who that is.
I don't look at the chat in game too much. But I tried to look at.
What was his number? 475?
Yeah. And blank name is wondering why he got black flag.
That is Kale Cimarron.
Oh well. If you race without a name, no you name. Blame yourself. I think it was one of the guys gooning in the 01 server a few days ago as well. Yeah, I'm looking at Twitch chat. I just didn't really think it was anything regarding me the last bit here. So I'm trying at least.
Oh, can... Jesus Christ, that deserves a ban from the server.
What?
I wouldn't open that in the stream. God damn.
You can read. I guess people are mature enough. So, warning, people. Heavy words incoming.
Yep. Trigger warning.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm trying to keep it rather clean, but I don't blame anyone for cursing as well. I don't believe in censorship, and I believe that every 10-year-old knows exactly every curse ever. You might not have to
go into... It just annoys me when that's their entire vocabulary.
Yeah.
That's... Where are your parents?
Apparently not by their PC. So Francis Heather with another good start here, top 2. So Francis Heather, 2 good starts, faded back quite a bit last time, and Brooke Papa with a good start here. Not see much of him this year. Brooke Papa is sort of this guy for me that either he's in or either he's just way out. It's like either he's one of the top guys, he's just not there. But he's also not showing up to EMF too much either, so I guess it would
be... He has been racing in real life, I'm pretty sure, though.
Yeah, and I think he's racing RF more consistently, or frequently than EMF, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
So I guess we'd... I mean, I don't expect people from a completely different time zone to show up to this.
Hey, you expect me to show up, damn it.
Oh yeah, but you are you. No, but seriously, I mean, like, it's if in the middle of the day you may have stuff to do, actually. So, yeah.
Dennis is in 5th. That's a decent start.
Compared to last time, it's a wonderful start. Not having to make his way through the over half the pack. And Dennis currently battling with Thomas Bento for 4th. Oh, Thomas Bento just taking a tour of the compound. Wow.
Yeah, that was... He just appreciates the work.
Yeah, wanna look at the details. So Dennis now up to 4th. Not much happening here in the top 3, and Dennis has currently 10 seconds after Connor Lynch, so one crash and Connor will have Dennis closest.
Elliot Phillips gets put in the ground by Jeffrey Gill.
Who?
Jeffrey Gill, Elliot Phillips down.
Oh.
Going on to the finish line jump.
I do realize that I don't see any Victor Nycott in this race. Nycott being one of the heavy hitters as well. Logan Deepad, unfortunately a previous champion. Back in 32nd, I believe, is even...
No, it's screwed. I'm not racing. I'm gonna go put skins in my folder. I don't care about FPS as long as it's over 30.
Yeah. Oh, Brooke Papa getting so squirrely, and he has a charging Dennis Fjellberg that's just jumping over the bales behind him. He does not want to look back, and Dennis scrubbing that jump, that's so sketchy. I would not have done that in that situation, especially since there are a few bumps, which are not too sketchy, but the whole jump there is... I mean, it's so easy to just get... Oh, look at this, a four-way battle for first place. Let's go back to that terrible jump later. So Dennis Fjellberg currently on the outside going off the track, but I guess that should be allowed because they do go off the track in real life quite often. So Fjellberg tried to scrap inside of Pappy, making it happen. Three guys to the inside and Pappy to the second inside. Dennis Fjellberg currently having Francis Heder in front of him, switching up lines nicely to not collide. And in the lead we have Conor Lins. So Fjellberg to the inside, oh, making the pass happen.
That was a nice pass.
Fjellberg charging, 140 flat, 0.6 last time, 140 flat, 0.6, that doesn't sound very good. Fjellberg getting a little bit upset there, out of the turn I think. Conor Lins with a 3 second lead to Fjellberg, that is nothing. One mistake and Fjellberg will be on the tail here. So I wanna see if Fjellberg comes up, no problem. Conor seems to take the outside, Fjellberg the very inside. Sketchy but very fast line. Just have to check so I don't have any sound muted here, that would be so terrible. Oh, seems to have sound going.
Oh, Francis ruined it. They're throwing sick whips over the finish line, he just straight aired it.
Sorry, I'm sort of looking at the chat at the moment as well. So, Conor Lins, not sure if he's pulling away from Fjellberg or Fjellberg's making mistakes. Francis Heder first, and Francis Heder with another good ride. Had a really great race going last race, I think he... what? We hit each other mid-air? That was nowhere near a jump, so I don't think that was... yeah, I'm going to skip away from the chat now.
Hopefully it has 101 results. Damn it, it doesn't.
Who's that down? That was... Could that bring Brock Pappy? Down there? Yeah, that was Pappy. So Pappy going down to 7th. Not that far off, still.
And Tristan collided with him while they were trying to land over the wall. That's gonna take Tristan down. Morgi Fabregatus gonna be right behind him now.
Oh, Anton Agosto.
There's actually a decent train going on.
Yeah, we have 5 guys in
eighth,
the train.
9th, 10th, 11th.
Tristan Bottom leading. Oh, that's Pappy down again, really? Mori Fabregatus, that is 134 of... Ooh, who's that? The number does not seem to match the actual skin. But it would have been Jonathan Hughes. I believe he's running in...
Probably an RF number or something like that.
Yeah, and that's sort of, honestly, a rule that we have that you should have matching, but that's nothing I'm gonna enforce. And to the lead,
yeah.
Dennis Fjellberg has made a move for the leader. So this is going to be interesting, and Dennis makes the inside...
Oh, and he goes down!
And that was, honestly, just the thing I was waiting for. Because that line is so sketchy. Oh. If you, especially if you try to jump up, if you don't try to jump, it's not too weird. But if you try to jump that,
yeah,
that's not going to be good, some lap. So that cost the lead, unfortunately. Team Friedrich now up to 3rd, and this guy, I think, moved up to Pro 1 or 2 weeks ago. So 3rd in his first or second Pro race, that's impressive. He's gonna around Francis Heather for third place and Francis Heather in fourth. Also not able to get a drive out of landing in the hole. So glad I put a little bit of a hole there. So Jacob Holgersson currently in fourth. Francis Heather followed by Fred Heather. Can never remember the story if they're actually related or not. I did speak to Fred, I believe, on TeamSpeak a while back, but I can't remember. Sorry.
I know, they're both numbers end with 13.
So. Yeah, as well as Edward Heather in amateur. I think it's 2:13, 5:13, and 6:13, so. Coincidence or not? No idea.
They're missing two brothers.
Yeah.
So, what are they getting a job or something? Come on.
Yeah. So two Husky guys followed by each other. Another guy with RF skin, I believe, Brock Puffy.
Should be.
Trying to find something interesting to watch here. So Jacob Holgersson, Fred Heather, and Francis Heather. Guess it couldn't be much better. And different lines, both guys going out strong out of the out on the southern straight turn. And this is going to be really interesting. I know Fred Heather had a great race going last week. I think he got a top three, if I can remember correctly. But looks like Jacob Holgersson is pulling away and Francis Heather is going getting closer to Fred Heather. And two different lines as well here coming on, and it looks like neither of them was really much faster than the other. Not even gonna fiddle with the cameras. Doubling out of there and making it happen. Looked like that actually was a faster line. Nice. So looks like Fred Heather finally cut back after Jacob Holgersson and Francis Heather lacking a little bit behind. And they might have one more guy in front of them, and that would be Tim Friedrich. No, that's a leper. 26 of Chase Dunneman. So Chase doing a great job of being a great leper. So Tim Friedrich still having a little bit of a cushion to Jacob Holgersson, and Chase just flipping. And so does Fred Heather. Fred Heather actually losing two positions to Tristan Bottram and Francis Heather. But it looks like the battle's on here between Tim and Jacob. Tim currently in 4th and Jacob in 5th. And neither of them launching too hard, giving them great drive, both of them. Connor Lynch with around 10 second lead over Dennis Fjellberg, so not much happening up in the top there. So I guess battle for
1st. He extended that by 3 seconds too.
Oh wow.
That will happen.
Probably. Oh, Conor Lynch with a 137. Oof. 137.4 according to my lifetime here. Oof, that's a tough one. But Tim Friedrich making the gap happen. Jacob Holgersson must have made a mistake because that was quite a significant gap difference for very little time. Michael Bucendik just out of top 10 here after having his first podium in pro. So Brock Puffy just going down south. Here in the standings.
Yeah, he's dropping. Maybe he didn't have enough time on the track. Who knows?
I would say choking. He had a great race going, but I guess stupid mistakes makes a difference. Ben Seberg finally has some speed, trying to catch Flo Lucas on, and that is for 15th. Looks like Ben is all over Flo here at the moment. Flo just looks like an anchor. Ben just
finished with a lead. Dennis is now leading.
Oh.
He has a 3 second gap right now. Connor had a 1:53. Wow. That is a blow up.
That's really fast.
Must have went down.
But I still want to see the battle here between Ben Seberger and Flo Lucas, and it's probably the best battle, and Ben finally making it happen. Not sure if Flo pulled to the side there to actually let him by, or just didn't want to put out for battle. With Flo trying to get around back on the inside, but that inside rod is, you don't have any momentum at all going out of it. So that's a hard thing trying to get back from. Sup Sorkin, Hagman finally coming back here. And we have around 7.5 minutes to go before the 2-lap card comes out. Connor Lynn's launching over the hole there, not getting stuck in that one, and wheelies through the straightaway. We have 450 Moto 2 left after this, so this would be 250 Moto 2. So Connor Lynn's trying to catch Dennis Fjällberg, but it seems to be no luck so far. I guess you could jump into TeamSpeak. That is Nick. So Heckman, check Facebook and you'll see. And Jacob Holgersson sliding out. Too bad. So that is going to leave Team Friedrich with the third place. Oh, Team Friedrich sliding out in the next turn. But I believe... Oh, Tim going down as well. Oh, but that's what when you're trying to get up in a hurry happens. And we do have Fred Heller as well. There. The in-game server is... It's easier if you go to mxscmf.com and check the racing server for either qualifying. That would be the easiest. Otherwise it's emfracing.mxcm.fr :19800. Let's see here. Fjällberg, Lynz, Heller, or Fred Heller, I should say, since we have three of them. Tim Friedrich, Tristan Bodram, Francis Heller, Jacob Holgersson. I don't want to continue here because it's actually a good battle. User entered your channel. I'll be right back, guys.
user joined your channel.
So, now we are fully equipped with commentators.
Hello?
Oh good, my internet turned back on.
Oh, hey.
Oh, great, it disconnected itself, turned back on, now the offset's gone.
So, Alex Heckman join us here as well. In the commentator booth.
We're in the server.
Yep. So let's
see here. Really good
that's
battle.
That's actually about
under
the
half
first
a second.
Place. So just as I go away for a split second, the battle is happening for first place. I should go away more often.
Damn.
And if they would finish like this, it would probably come down to cuts even. So one guy want to extend the lead over the other one. And Connor tries the inside.
Do I sound good, loud, quiet?
Going out sideways. But it was
and
fast.
He blames the track for his mistake.
Did he?
Yep.
Well, the track has been the same every lap, and if you just take the 1/100 of a second to go out straight out of that turn, you have no problem whatsoever. Unless you try to triple down from the inside, that could be sketchy.
So oh yeah.
I would not take that as a valid complaint, actually. If it would have come said fucking track after crashing before the jump, not this one, but the next one coming up in the acceleration bumps, that would have been totally valid. I would have even agreed.
Yeah, there's a lot. They're like moguls, they're not just like bumps.
They were a bit too big, I think. But they do prevent the triple as well, so I don't really know if it was good or bad. So Tristan Bottom battling with Francis Heder here, and Francis Heder getting aggressive, blocking out Tristan. And if these guys aren't really careful, that is going to allow Michael Bujendic to catch up. And we have somebody, I think that's a lapper.
Yeah, he's right there, it's a three-way battle now.
No, that's Jacob Holgersson, that's a four-way battle. That's Team Freelis, now it's a five-way battle, what is happening?
Oh man.
Guys dropping like rocks. Wow.
Forgetting I have cameras.
I don't even know what who to spectate or how to spectate. I think I'm just gonna go with.
I would just put the camera right on one like Michael.
I'm going to put the camera in the guy in front there. That's Francis Hederback battling with Michael Jandy. Both guys riding for Cycle Trader Yamaha. So I would be surprised with dirty moves. And this is the thing, as you can see here, that's a perfect example. Francis
synchronicity is beautiful.
Yeah. It was. But it looks
all
like
right,
Michael.
So now I got the object bag.
There you go.
So Francis Heder losing position, losing the position of Michael Bujendic there. Michael seeming just pulling away slightly. And Francis having to deal with Jacob Holgersson as well now. And behind Jacob, we should have Team Friedrich pretty soon, and we seem to have lost a guy. That would be Tristan Bottram down to 10th, unfortunately.
Wow.
But it looks like Francis Heder wants his position back. Like he wants to be in the 4th spot. Ooh, sketchy. And Francis Heder having
looks like a fun track.
Yeah, oof. I can't believe how sketchy he's riding at the moment. Looks like he got drunk mode in or something. Oh.
Oh, well, three-way battle, wow.
Yeah. So it's four guys relatively close up.
Jordan Moxie going for the pass on Thomas Bento.
That is just behind him, I would
say. Yep, for eighth place.
Moxie he's had quite a lot of success both in RF and EMF this year, especially moving up. I think it was amateur in the beginning of the year.
He just crashed though.
Embarrassing. I'm just talking about progress and then he crashes. That's timing well. Oh well.
Called the commentator curse.
That seems to happen about 50% of the time. It's very inconsistent. So Thomas Bento.
We got Holgersson. Oh. Holgersson got into the back of Heder.
And Heder, Francis Heder, seeming to be so sketchy at the moment. I wonder if this is Nick that's back.
Yep.
What the hell?
I think it's time that you spend the money on a fiber cable, build one yourself.
Oh yeah, for sure. Freaking 12 grand.
12 grand? I think it's more than 12 grand to lay your entirely own cable.
We need to pay the government to telephone poles because proper internet is apparently not a necessity in Canada.
RIP.
So, or Australia.
Cool. Oh yeah. But Australia has the...
Australia's internet is new. What the hell are we doing?
But the thing is with Australia, it has traveled such a great distance too. Even though fiber optics...
Just outside the top 10.
Oh yeah. Oh wow.
That's Barham, Moxie, Pevergetes, and Garcia. And Pappy too, not too far ahead.
I don't even know who to spectate at this point. I think Tristan Barham and Jordan Moxie would be great because these are two fast guys. I think Moxie could be a bit aggressive as well if he wants to. And Moxie... Oh,
speaking of it...
Going for a launch.
Oh my! Pappy just jumped across the entire track.
That turn is so sketchy because if you do eat off the inside, you have no idea where you're gonna go, and if you go to the outside, you're forced to jump to the right, so that's not set up for dualists for sure.
Moxie, another mistake.
So Moxie is going to drop back a bit here, coming down with two other guys.
Oh, they're both going down.
Oh, Bodram and Pappy.
Moxie's just gonna go by.
Thank you very much.
Oh no, Moxie turns it away.
This is looking to be interesting, I gotta say.
This is a good battle now. Morgie and Antonio just got past them both.
Update on the front, Fjeldberg only has a 2.5 second lead now.
Seems to happen things everywhere. Fjeldberg having a smaller lead.
Battle about to take the white flag as well, I believe. Yep.
We do have a three-way battle for... That is fifth.
Yep.
All Francis Heather going down. Leather. France is going down, and it seems like there's a battle going on for first place here.
Oh, yep, Hazard, almost under a second now.
This is the last lap, things could get dirty.
They've got a 40 second lead over Heather in third.
So they could get as dirty as they want, more or less, and they would still have plenty of time to not finish third. If we assume that cuts aren't a factor at the point. Things. I'm surprised why.
What's the bet he blames the track on that one?
I'm surprised why people actually do the inside in that turn because those bumps going into that are so big.
That's you have to hit it at like 2 miles an hour and just tap the throttle just to like wheelie over it.
You sort of have to stand up for most of the turn even just to get the suspension leverage.
Oh my god, sketchy.
I wonder if I
landed on a hay bale.
I wonder if the timing gauge allows that. They probably do since he has done that before. But it's a sketchy line for sure. That is Antonio Garcia, almost catching Fjellberg's back.
Checks up a little bit. Just takes one bad lapper and that is going to lose it.
And in front of him, I do see Tristan Barham, and it could be Flo Lucasson.
Here's the finish line though.
Yep.
Fjeldberg with Moto 2 victory.
Levy won Moto 1 as well, so Fjeldberg going 1-1 with Jet again.
Connor just goes down, so that's probably going to negate the effects of any cutting.
Yep.
That's true. So Fjeldberg has gone 1-1 in 3 rounds.
Oh, Francis Heather off the track. Michael.
We have a battle for third.
Fred Heather off the track as well.
Yeah.
So this is not too far behind, actually.
Are they related?
I have no idea, because there are two...
On different teams.
Francis Heather and Fred Heather in pro, and we have Edward Heather in amateur, and both... and everyone has... It's... What is it? Number... Is it... 5, 13, 6, 13, and 2, 13, I think, so... I don't know, I did speak to Fred Heather on TeamSpeak a while ago, but I can't remember what he said. Was so many guys talking at once and I was tired.
Fred Heather with the third.
Michael Buccelli with the fourth.
Yeah, I was gonna say I'm gonna murder that name.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe not. Jacob, he loses it.
No. He does what I did. I wonder if he loses two more positions. It seems like he's not going to.
No.
I did this exactly the same thing. I went down last turn, losing three positions, getting one back on cats though.
Oh, Francis Heather taking seven.
Yep. Thomas Bento, Morty Farreglas, Flo Lucasons, I was right, there was Flo. Tristan Ballram.
Tristan's last on the track.
More or less, yeah, he was finished.
Tristan has not been happy in chat.
Look at all the rage quits. Oh my lord.
I might have to race next round.
I think you should.
You had to beat two people to score a paint. Freaking internet. Basically, Alex, my internet just for some reason shot up to 400 ping, 30 offset. I had to disconnect off the start.
Oh wow.
Yep.
My internet during the
live. And then it shut off twice or three times now, and now it's perfect. I don't understand.
Brock Puppy losing one spot on cuts here from, I believe, 13th to 14th.
It looks like it, yep.
So
during a high point, my internet went to about 1,000 offset, but I just trudged through it. It only lasted about a quarter of a lap. I hope I didn't kill anybody.
RF doesn't ban for bad internet, right?
Not right away.
To a certain degree.
Yeah, like, they're not gonna kick you if you have a certain ping, or offset, whatever.
And that is...
I guess they do if it's really bad. But there's no, like, set limit.
Was this warm-up lap?
Yep.
So, because I have... That's been one of the complaints about RF not kicking Aussies for lagging terribly. So it's... And since I don't really race RF, or I race
round RF is also hosted on American servers, which is better for them.
Yeah, that's true, but... They still seem to lag quite a bit.
Yeah.
Keep an eye out for my buddy Ethan Parks in this one.
And I think you should tell your buddy there to send me his skins. It's second week in a row, I believe, I don't see him.
I think... I don't remember. I've been talking to him. I haven't been talking to him.
I think he was running top 5 last week, and I still didn't see his skins. I was really bothered.
Yeah, he's been getting top 10s. Pretty pumped.
Yeah, running good for sure.
Just started scoring points in RF too, so he's definitely finding a flow.
Yes, scoring points in RF.
Who is that launching? Oh, Matthias Lidman. He's launched that wall.
Tripling? Or?
No, the wall on over the start.
Oh.
I wanna figure out a good third person setup.
Third so person?
Just ride around in third person for the first lap.
Do what I have. Stock.
I have stock.
Well, I want to use the same FOV so I can just press tab and change it.
What's your FOV in first person?
120.
Jeez.
Yeah. Good luck.
Then you would have to decrease distance, I would say. Quite a bit. To 7 or something, perhaps.
Otherwise, you'd be way too far
I got something.
Behind it.
I got 120. 4-7 Titan distance.
I'm gonna go grab a water real quick, I'll be right back.
Sounds good.
And how did I used to play in third person?
How do you still not? See,
I mean, I know
the
how.
Argument
it's
can
just,
go two ways.
I'm out of practice.
So we have Walter Gebhardt here. I must spectate Walter Gebhardt for the start. Oh, he's far outside. I don't think so. So let's
go. I can do that.
With Liedman, if find him instead.
Oh.
Screw that. Yannick Müller. Müller,
back
track.
Just in time.
Let's see. Müller with a bad jump. Tianan and Tyson.
Tianan with a great jump.
Yeah. Oof.
Wow. Walter just hunted Bruno.
Really?
And he disconnected. Yep. I would say that was intentional.
It seems so. If that's...
Well, if it was specifically Bruno.
Oh, Root going down.
Hey, wait, Bruno.
Like, I don't know, maybe Bruno's he just wanted to punt somebody and just disconnect? Who knows? Maybe he's just over it. Maybe he wasn't trying to punt anyone at all. Who knows?
Bruno's in 22nd right now.
Yeah, Bruno's actually staying up, so I doubt that was Bruno being punted.
Oh, no, it was definitely Bruno.
No, because Bruno's in 22nd and he didn't
see the pile up the first turn.
But he still had too good of a start to make that two gone down. I don't know. I'll have to review.
He definitely got sidechecked.
So we got Tianen, Tyson, and I can't say that guy in third.
Binu Kreisch. It's European names. It's like every European country or like, I guess a few of them have similar names, but it's just to take your best shot. Not even me living in Europe can say them, so.
I mean, I speak a little bit of French, I guess that helped, but not really.
Ethan Parks in fifth place.
Hey, if there's someone French, I got you.
Well, Root, after his first lap crash, is now up to 9th. 10th, rather.
And Maxim Tyson with another good start, second place, and I think it was second place out of the turn as well.
Yeah.
That looks great.
Yep, he started second.
Tyson, we'll see how far Valtteri can check out now, if he can at all.
I think he will. But I'm really impressed by my buddy Tyson here, and the co-host there, and admin and whatnot of EMF. He's really been picking up the pace lately, especially outdoors, been getting great results.
He must like outdoors more than Supercross.
J-Cross not able to stop for Jordan, Bini Kravitz there, too bad.
So that is Ethan Park's position.
Yeah, so Park's going to get by there. Jake Rossi is going to have to settle for fifth after that crash. Still not bad. Drew Swanson, Owen Hillman. So Hillman with another good start. Jack Fowler, Hunter Root, Wesley Lemoyne, Frontland Billen, Logan Litzel, Johan Meyer. So our admin back in racing. Always great to see.
Yep. Alex Hunter Munch. Flips.
And Mr.
In
down.
11th. It's going to lose a couple spots.
Going to go back to 14th. 15th.
And Matthias
16th.
Oh, Matthias Lehmann punting Ponsa. I don't think that was intentional. Matthias Lehmann just had it inside. And two guys that worth to know here. Adora Merrot, second in points, is currently 16th. And Matthias Lehmann, I believe, 4th or 5th in points. 16th. So these guys are definitely going to have to work their way back up to score some points.
Hunter just got way overzealous. I don't know what he was doing.
Is he the points leader?
Root is points leader by, I believe, 2 points or 3 or...
Oh, wow.
It's really close.
Yeah.
I believe Tiano would have been up there as well if he hadn't missed 2 races in a row. Hunter
Root... Right now he's starting to check out this a little bit.
Yeah, he's close to do that.
What was the lead at the end of the first moto? 50 seconds?
60 seconds by finish.
Insane.
Who won it?
Tiano.
Valtteri, he checked out the entire time.
Oh, wow.
He and Jannik was battling for quite a good time, but Tiennan just dropped the hammer and started putting the laps down.
Where is Jannik, though?
Bad news for everyone else that he's leading.
20.
Oh, he's in 20th, no.
Yeah. Jake Rose now up to 3rd, so going around Ethan Parks.
And Jake Rose was just an amateur and went pro halfway through the Supercross season.
Yeah, I think he...
Oh, he's definitely improved.
If he went pro, I believe, before...
Two or three rounds to go.
Yeah.
Hunter just forced Johan into some of the bales on top of the scrub hill.
Johan Meyer?
That's a crazy group of riders. 15th back.
The Hunter's quite a way down there. Oh, interesting.
He's in 13th now, so
struggling,
he gets around.
For traction, to say the least.
And I can't believe it.
He's been struggling for an outdoor setup, period. Ever since the new suspension.
Yeah.
I can't believe how people are struggling with traction on this track. I had a few guys saying that the traction is bad. To me it feels like asphalt.
Well, I liked it.
I feel like it's too much traction, actually.
No matter how great you make the track, someone's always going to complain.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, Jack Fowler lands on Dorian.
Wow. Hunter gets
and
3 spots.
And Hunter goes by, so now he's going to extend it.
And Jannik Mueller is actually going to gain a few positions of that, so Mueller now up to 13th.
Wow. Mueller almost got in the back of Matt Agut.
Matt Agut is also another guy that's been really improving.
Oh, and they get together, it looks like a little lag maybe.
I don't know, I think that was two guys...
He kind of forced it.
Yeah.
Maybe that was my lag then.
Yeah, I didn't see any lag, but it felt like two guys fighting for the same real estate, and neither of them shaked up, but
maybe he didn't hear him or something on the inside.
I don't know. I think
Mueller... I know that happened to me in the first moto because freaking ear goes.
I know that
hearing.
Mueller has played in third person.
Great.
He switched to first person, came back to third, and then won a race. So I think he stayed third since. But I still feel like that was a weird call. I would have backed off on the inside, I think, if I was the guy trying to make the pass.
Arcs loses a spot, goes back to fifth now.
If he closes out, there's nothing you can do.
Yeah.
We got a three-way battle for third right now.
I must say, Tyson's impressing his thing on the back of Tianan, just 5 seconds behind. Tianan with a 136, really?
But Tyson's staying consistent, 141s.
Yeah. Oh, 1/10 of a second just off. And for third, we have Binu Kravitz in third. Jake
third
in fourth.
And fourth with the same lap time.
And then we have Ethan Parks and Owen Hillman for their four-way battle, or four-way trail.
And they got quite a bit of a gap over seven.
That is correct. Jordan Boyer and Alex Munch is way back.
They're going at it, too.
Yeah, fighting hard. Hunter Root, 10th.
Not making up too many spots.
No, he's usually so fast, but I've noticed that sometimes he just cannot get going.
Well, he's been down a couple times because he's just trying to force it around people.
And that's the thing, the same with me.
Like, he launched the wall after the finish line and pulled it, and then just jumped into somebody after the single.
Oh, Tianan and Tyson getting together, Tianan went down in the corner. Oh, Tyson ran into the back of him.
And Tyson going for the double out. I think like that's such a sketchy line, because if you come up short or long, that could really ruin your day, especially if you get a little huckabuck going off the single.
Oh, Tianan turned a 136.6 that last lap.
Really? Improving even more.
Tyson with a 140.3 though.
These guys are so fast and so consistent, it's just sad to watch.
Parks thing is, a 140 is a good lap, and then Valtteri is 4 seconds faster.
Yeah, just think about that. Well, Hillman gets up to 5th, Parks' mistake.
Plom in chat, I don't know who we are from form or such. But I don't have the Muddy Creek demos, I have only raced Pro AMA the first Hangtown round, and I don't have a single demo other than that, so
can't. I don't either, sorry.
So yeah, you have to go to ask
only person phone. That's dropped into a 130 other than Valtteri has been Hunter Root so far.
That was his last lap too, wasn't it?
Yep. Yeah, there's something to keep an eye on, I guess.
Guess he charges his way through.
They've opened up the gap here at the top two. They have around 15 seconds down to Jake Rose in third, and Jake Rose actually got on around Binut Kravitz. Oh, Kravitz going sideways, flipping and dying. So Hillman...
dying.
Yeah, he died big time. So Hillman is now going to get here, and Hillman is going to get fourth, so Kravitz is going to have to go to fifth. Parks, sixth. Jordan Boyer and a launching route behind him in 8th. And Mueller 9th, so... what I would claim
Matthew Massurin in 15th.
Yeah, Monsieur not having a good race today.
And then he gets taken out by someone by re-entering the track. That's Dorian Merritt.
That sucks, and Merritt... should also be up there in the top 5 battling it out. But apparently not having too great of a race. That's Jack Fowler.
Oh, and Hillman goes down in 5th.
Oh, I see Parks gets around him. Yep. Jumps right over him.
Tianan down.
Boyer's gonna be right behind him as well.
Tianan down?
Yeah, so battle for first.
Tianan
was down with what I believe would be a lapper. Can't see who that is. That would be...
I can check.
Somebody got closer. So battle for first place on.
Matt Model.
Possibly. Oh, Tianan almost crashing.
Oh, Chris Channing just destroyed Matthew Lemoine as I was flipping through. That looked... there's no way that was an accident. That was just too violent.
No idea. I didn't see it.
Tyson six. Keeping it right there to second.
Yeah, Tyson doing a great job of hanging on to Tiana. What do you say about my fifth place in Moto 2? That was my third pro race. I say good racing. I can't remember who from the results. But great. If it's third pro race, that's really great to get fifth. And Tiana went down.
Uh-oh, so Jake Rose shuddering through, laggy, third.
Oh, man.
It doesn't seem too laggy, though.
He's
completely invisible for me.
Oh, not for me. That was good.
He's good. There we go.
He seemed to lag just a tad for just
it's,
a little
it's
bit.
Smooth, but he's not there.
Yeah.
And the thing is...
But Tyson with the lead, anyway.
Oh, yeah, I'm the only guy. Can I see Jake Rose? I can't see the ping, unfortunately. I can't kick him because it seems smooth on my screen, and that would be very weird to kick Jake. St. Louis.
Well, I can tell you if he gets into anybody, I can watch.
There's no way to scroll up or down, that's t-
Yeah, that's... Oh, Jake.
Yeah, why is that?
Well, he lost the spot to, that... I'm gonna butcher that name.
Benoit Gravic. Yeah.
That's the thing, because if it... Oh, I hate having to deal with lag in this situation.
Park's up to 5th, though, with Root working his way up to 6th now.
Seems to be okay now. Maybe something on his phone was updating, like an app or something.
Yeah, that could be. Oh! Park's getting sketchier in front of Root.
Yeah, come on, Ethan. What are you doing?
Root, do you think Root is going to triple?
Oh! Valtteri is losing time.
Oh, Root's going to jump right past Parks.
Root with this sick line there. And if...
Oh yeah, Tyson with a 15 second lead.
Yeah, Tyson doing a great job. And I just want to address the lag. Since if you're in spectate mode, you are offset by 1 second. You're offset by 1 second, and that is to make the game look smoother, and that includes lag. Yep. So if a guy has 200 in ping, he's most likely going to appear super
smooth.
It'll
look like it has 100.
He's going to look smooth in the demo slash.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Play spectator mode, but he's going to look really, really laggy in game. That's a problem.
Oh, Jake Rose, he crashes again and sits. That's gonna let Parks by.
And I can't see anyone
right in the back
over 300 at the moment. We have some people right around the edge. And if a rider is all by himself and gets a little bit of a lag spike, you can't kick the guy immediately.
Yeah, it might just be a 1 second thing.
Yeah, because if you kick someone for 1 second, it completely resets. If you destroy...
We're gonna be racing with two people.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, more or less everyone's internet does that.
Yeah.
So...
Especially mine.
Three guys up in front here. We have Tyson, Tiana, and Root. This could be really interesting because there's 10 and a half minutes to go before two laps.
That was... Root's gonna have to put down the hammer to catch him, though.
Valtteri just ran a 137 flat as well.
That's sick. Oh, Jake
Ross. Tyson dropped his fastest, too.
Jake Ross landing on top of... Owen Hillman. Owen, why the fucking... That was a weird one because... I don't know what Owen did. Jake just straight up landed on Owen. It didn't even look like Owen shaked up or anything.
Rose might have been lagging and invisible for Hillman. As Hillman whips it right in front of Bowyer and takes Bowyer out.
Ooh. And Bowyer just got into the rig Jake Rose when Jake was just laying down, so I guess... That was not more fair. And behind him we have Morgan Morlett and Yannick Müller. So Müller finally trying to get into the top 10 here.
And 10th going for 9th.
Yeah. Let's see if he can double.
Maybe
from the
jump
outside.
This. Nope.
Nope. And the thing
is a safe line.
On inside, it's not much breaking bumps, but it's a big, big rut. So that's not too good to jump from. The outside has so big bumps.
Jake rolls down again. Well, everyone's gonna get past him here.
Oh, going down to 10th. He's not going to be happy with that one.
He's up in third early.
Yeah. I mean, he's been so fast, and he's usually not a 450 rider either. He's been riding 250 as long as I can remember when I started playing with him when he was new to the game. So that's weird to see, but he's definitely fast on the 450. I just think he needs
to be my buddy in fifth right now. I'll make sure he'll get his skin sent to you.
Yeah, do so. I mean, I would like to tell everyone to send their skins, but it's just, I don't want to go for a few hours in the forum and just download skins.
Yeah.
I just
want bad news for the second place in points. He's in 21st in this moto.
That would
Oh, Root fell back to 4th.
Dorian Merritt.
That was Jordan Boyer going down. So close.
Root must have made a mistake.
Up in 20th now, he's going to score 1 point. Meanwhile, Hunter is scoring 20. No, 18.
So Tianan made up almost 2.5 seconds that last lap. And Tyson with a mistake slides out at the top of the hill. But Tyson otherwise being really consistent.
Oh, Root passing a few guys down on the ground. That's the 2-2-2 of Bruno. So Bruno not having as good of a race as last time. He had a 10th place finish last time around, and he's 27th now, so not that good of a race.
Yeah, he's dead last, just cruising.
Mark's dealing with a couple lappers here that won't move out of the way.
That would be...
Oh, Park slides it out. He might lose a spot to Hillman here.
301 is Drew Swenson.
So Hillman's going to get right up close and personal here. Let's see if it does
Hillman.
Anything. Hillman usually being a very vocal guy in chat.
I noticed that.
Haven't seen Parks post anything ever, I think, so...
Nope. He has yet to rage quit a race, Parks has. He's been playing for over a year.
That is
proud of it.
I don't think I've ever rage quit a race. I have quit one. I quit the ARC one because being dead last. I could have finished, but it just feels stupid to finish when you're dead last. I don't know.
Well, Hillman gets around him.
I'll try. Yeah, Hillman's on fire. Hillman's fifth now. Hunter.
Oh, Stork, and you were mad, so you quit. That's the story.
Yeah.
Oh, well, Crowridge off the track there a little bit.
But Maxim Tyson's... what happened to Tianan? My light
made
aiming
a lot of mistakes
showed...
here.
No, but light aiming showed him as 1,000 seconds behind.
No, he's only 16.
Yeah, but it was just for one timing it, so something crazy happened to the live timing for sure. He'll be so sad if he disconnected now. So we have roughly 5 minutes to go before the 2 lap sign comes out, so around 10 minutes to go.
Tyson seems to tone down his speed a little bit. Trying to be consistent.
But I gotta say, Tyson now breaking into the 130 range as well. So going great.
That was a couple laps ago, yep.
And Tiana second place, still around 15 seconds to go, and Hunter Root, I think, is too far off both of these riders to be able to do the slightest thing.
Take some bad luck with lappers, probably, to make anything happen there.
Yeah, I don't see that happening. Bino Kravitz, fourth place, solo race. Owen Hillman, solidly in fifth. Ethan Parks, just behind. Yannick Mueller, 7th, Nick Rip again. So Yannick Mueller finally into the top 10 after having such a great first moto. Whipping it good, Morgan Marlett. 8th, Jordan Boyer 9th, and Steen Elshoff 10th. I have no idea if that's a correct pronunciation, but I'll assume it is. Matthew Mosseron. Followed by Alex Monch and Matthias Lindman. So Matthias Lindman finally back into the top 15th. after not having a very good start to Dylan Ogdebury and Jake Rose.
He's getting lapped by Tyson there. Tyson
and
trying
Jake
to go to
Rose
inside.
Having such a good start. And
if Tyson can get around Ogilvy here.
Yeah, and that would be the obstacle at the moment, because Dylan does not seem to give up the spots to Tyson.
He is not moving.
And that's very disrespectful.
Oh, there he goes.
There he is. But he is going to lose a position to Jake Rose as well.
That's what he didn't want to do, is lose that position. He doubles it.
Almost triple.
Oh, Monch is dying on the ground. They're going to both get past him. Dorian Merritt, you said he's second in points?
Yeah.
17th now.
So
he's turned to 137.
Oh, that's fast. That's fast for sure. But not scoring very many points, but I still think he'll keep second place in there. But he's going to lose a lot of points to Hunter Root.
Yeah.
That's unfortunate.
User entered your channel. 7 people have rage quit. Well, including Walter. So Nick is back?
Freaking internet. God damn.
Tyson's starting to, he's just turned to 139.4, so I guess he wasn't backing it down at all.
I don't think so. I mean, it's only around 8 minutes
16
to go
second
until it's over.
Tiennan's gonna have to push.
Yeah, I don't think Tiennan's gonna catch him right out of speed. Feels like Tiennan is not consistent enough at the moment. Unless Tyson makes mistakes. So mistake-free Tyson is probably going to take this, but if both guys race clean, it could be close since Tiennan seemed to be faster.
Rude just did a mini oppo whip over that wall on accident.
Because why not? Rude having quite a crashing back to fourth with Binus Kravic.
Hilmas trying to get around a lapper and took a different line and must have kicked him.
Probably so. And Mueller now around Eaton Parks there for 6th place, so Mueller trying to score as many points as he can for the home track.
Park's still top 10.
Yeah. But probably not going to get the overall as I guess he would have wanted to have. The overall at the moment would go to Valtteri Tiennan with a 1-2. I think Root finished second last time, so Tyson, even if Tyson finished third last time, he's not going to get it. But I believe Mueller finished third last time, so Tiennan looking to be the overall winner from this race, and he really needs the points if he want to win this championship.
How many more rounds are left?
This is 6 of 14 planned.
Alright, we're not even halfway yet?
Yeah, we yet have to make a few rounds and stuff, so we really hope to get 14 rounds, but there's nothing guaranteed, unfortunately. So Tyson now having to deal with lappers here, that is going to be one interesting thing. As we have number 78
cutting over on him.
And not
letting
him
by. Oh, he gets to the line before the 25 minutes, so it's going to be 3 to go now.
And that is, let me see, is that Steam Elshoff battling out with perhaps Matthias Liedman? So
I
finally
believe
at least got around.
Yes,
him.
It was. It was, Matthew Masurin getting around him. Dorian Merritt up to 13th now, right behind these guys.
Root almost going down.
Oh, he's always going down. Almost going down.
He's pushing hard, you can tell now. He's all over
the
place.
He just turned to 137 and this lap at 138, so.
Wow.
And Matthias Liedman is the next one to be lapped by Maxim Tyson. And Liedman finally into the top 10 of this, again having a bad start. Matthew Mazeron, mediocre race, expected to be up top. I don't know what more to say. I guess bad starts can screw it up for you. So, Mueller with a 138.7 is the fastest lap time, just shorting to the finish line.
Oh, Maxime goes down!
Oh, that is.
Uh oh, so that's gonna shorten it under 10 seconds now.
Tiennan's gonna be close, not gonna get him.
Tiennan's way far off, and Tiennan almost going down himself.
Yeah, he just got a call too, he just hit the boost button.
So, he's in 6th now. Or 6 seconds behind him. Pardon me.
Yeah.
Did you see- Oh, Tyson down again! He got legs off! So Tien can take the lead.
The tilt.
That was a weird legs off, too. He probably wasn't expecting that one.
I believe... what? I'll have to shake the demo because Jake Rose is just sort of being not very respectful in chat now. Gonna have to go back review. Oh, I missed the Tyson lost the position.
Yep, Tyson got legs off, jumping the wall onto the starting line.
Oh.
Really weird legs off.
But the thing is, with the starting line, if you don't jump very far, there's it's sort of a hole. Like, if you don't jump very much, you won't get in. But if you jump sort of medium-sized, you'll probably land in the end of the hole, and that may cause your motor cover, if that's what it's called, underneath the bike to catch and make you fall off.
Yeah.
So
that's unfortunate.
Yeah, so you either have to launch low to mid, very low to low medium, or very very far to more or less be sure to not have the legs off. And Tianan just shaking out at the moment, just pulling away from Tyson here, and I feel bad for Tyson because he's had such a good race going.
That allowed Root to close in almost 10 seconds behind.
Yeah, so Root close for sure. And Hillman up to 4th.
Mueller up to 5th. Or maybe he was there, I can't remember.
No, I think he just got up to 5th because I remember him being in the 6th. So this is really interesting. One mistake by Tianan, and he is going to hand over the lead to Monsieur.
There's the next time around is a white flag as well.
Yep, and yep. That is
so the coming to it.
5 going down.
Oh, Tyson had a mistake.
I think that
Dorian
was more
Merritt is up to 10th, by the way.
Who? Oh, Merritt. Yeah. Oh, Tyson losing so much time. I think that's Jordan Boyer down there. So Tyson now being 9 seconds behind, and around 10 seconds is the magic mark for one crash.
Root that... just turned a 137 flat.
So Root definitely putting on a charger. Yeah. That's Morgan Morlett behind Maxim Tyson.
Hillman lost the spot to Mueller as well.
That was just what I was about to say. It looks like Bino Kravitz is trying to get Hillman back for, or back and back, but trying to get a spot.
Oh, Maxim goes down again.
Oh no.
Oh, so he's going to lose a spot to
Root.
He's
losing that second place now.
I was lucky. I thought from the camera angle I had, it was just diving in front of Hunter, but that was fortunately not what happened.
It was close.
Yeah, so we could more or less guarantee Valtteri the win at the moment.
Yeah, but the 15-second lead, take more than a fall-off to Austin.
Yeah, he could roll the rest of the jumps.
Yeah.
Oh, big swap.
So Tianan looking to win this, Root probably going to finish second. Tyson down again.
Another mistake. But they've got 30 seconds over Mueller.
Oh, no, really? Tyson, what are you doing? Just... why? Oh, don't tell me he died.
He wanted to go for a swim.
So Valtteri Tianan is going to go 1-1 here in Germany, Teutschenthal. Great race.
Yep.
With 1:36.6 as his fastest lap time.
Crazy.
Hunter Root.
See what Root's lap time here is.
Yeah, that's going to be fast.
1:36.5.
Last lap.
Wow.
Holy moly.
And didn't die there either. Come on.
No, he's dead.
Now he's dead, but not from the landing.
And Maxim Tyson.
Tyson
here.
After leading a lot of it.
Unfortunately, just falling back, watch a 1:57 lap time, that's not where he wants to be. Yannick Mueller worked his way back all the way up to 3rd, and that's 2 guys flipping. It's a good race by Mueller, not really that. Probably wanted to be in a better position, but considering that he had to work his way through, I'm sure he's more than happy with the position.
That should give him 3rd or 4th overall as well.
Probably
gonna
so, yeah.
Gonna be closer to him and Tyson.
Hillman getting the top 5.
Didn't they finish
in struggles?
Oh, Benoit had mistakes with Lappin.
I believe. Or never mind, no. Just gonna give it to...
Hillman not happy with himself in chat. Buddy Park's gonna take home a 7th. And Merritt all the way up to 8th. Wow.
I have to go in a hurry.
Alright, so, okay. You're stroking.
Yeah, see you guys next week. Thanks for coming in.
Yep. No problem.
See ya.